Hello, I'm Dr. Rob Califf, Vice Chancellor for Clinical and Translational Research at Duke University and PI of the Coordinating Center of the NIH Healthcare Systems Research Collaboratory.
Learning from effective business practices.
You know, when we look at Amazon and Walmart or companies like Google, everything you do is recorded as you interact with them, and then they use that information to make your experience better. Obviously, also in their cases, the endpoint is profitability. For the companies, there's a little bit of a mixed motive there, but we're very accustomed to the fact, for example, that when you walk into a Walmart store, you purchase things, you walk around the store, depending on where items are on the shelf or how the clerk interacts with you, you may make different purchases. All that information is recorded, it's captured, it's put into a data warehouse, and analyses are done. I've learned recently, for example, Walmart actually does randomized trials of where things should be in a store because sometimes that's the best way to find out. And so healthcare, now that we have electronic transactions, electronic health records for almost everyone in America, healthcare could record that information, analyze it, and then make the next person's experience better. Or if you're only interested in yourself, it could analyze the information so that your next experience with the healthcare system would be improved, or you might have a better chance of getting the right treatment. So standard practices of business now really could be quite useful in healthcare.
The Healthcare Systems Research Collaboratory.
We've had a lot of fun with the Healthcare Systems Research Collaboratory. It's only a year old, but we have an initial group of projects which I think will give us a lot of interesting answers to questions about healthcare delivery. The projects themselves are each answering an important question. For example, how long should your dialysis run be if you require dialysis? You might think we know the answer to that question already, but we don't. But beyond each individual project, the systematic approach to healthcare systems and how to understand better, how to design studies that answer these questions will be a long-lasting contribution of the collaboratory. There's so many things we don't know about healthcare, sort of a wide-open universe of questions. We just need an efficient way to get the answers. Then everyone will come out better because our healthcare experiences will be better and our choices will be better about the right treatments.
The National Patient-Centered Clinical Research Network, PCORnet.
One of the amazing things that happens, you never know why these things happen in your career, but we had the opportunity to work on the collaboratory, and that was a tremendous experience from the beginning. But in the midst of all this, the Patient-Centered Outcomes Research Institute came out with a new proposal to develop a very large national network that might involve tens of millions of Americans and their health systems. And it turned out what PCORI was looking for was exactly what we were doing in the collaboratory. And so they have created now PCORnet, which will actually be announced tomorrow in terms of the entire network, but it will involve millions of Americans. And the way I think about it is the collaboratory designed by the NIH as a common fund project is meant to be high risk, where we can do experiments, try out different ways of doing clinical studies, learn from it. And then PCORnet is a massive implementation exercise to take what we've learned and apply that in the conduct of research on a very large scale with very diverse populations in America. So it's a very nice continuum from experimental, high risk, high chance of failure in the collaboratory, but also tremendous opportunity if we succeed and learn from that and apply it on a much larger scale in PCORnet.